Hello dear children, let us start chapter 3, Laws of Motion, part E, Gravitation. In the previous video, we had discussed about motion of a freely falling body, equations of motion and comparison of mass and weight. In this video, our objective is to learn the following topics: relationship between weight and mass, gravitational unit of weight and force. We'll discuss some application based question and numerical questions. So let us start today's session. Let us learn about the relationship between weight and mass. Children, we know very well that weight is a vector quantity and the SI unit of weight is Newton. Yes, Newton. And the CGS unit of weight is dyne. Okay, now we know the relationship between Newton and dyne. 1 Newton is equal to 10 to the power 5 dyne. Yes or no? How, children, 1 Newton is equal to 10 to the power 1 Newton is equal to 10 to the power 5 dyne. So how can we prove that 1 Newton is equal to 10 to the power 5 dyne? See, children, 1 Newton is equal to 1 kg into 1 meter per second square. Okay, or we can write like this: 1000 gram into 100 centimeter per second square. Or we can write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10 to the power 5 gram centimeter per second square. So this is nothing but your dyne. D-Y-N-E, dyne. Okay, so we can write like that: 1 Newton is equal to 10 to the power 5 dyne. Okay, now, so what should be the relationship between weight and mass? Okay, weight is nothing but equal to mass into acceleration due to gravity. So we can write W is equal to M into G, or W is equal to mg. Since we know, children, the value of G varies from place to place, so the weight of a body will also vary from place to place. Now let us learn the gravitational unit of weight and force. Children, one similarity we can find between weight and force, that the unit of weight is Newton and force is also Newton. Okay, so now you see, gravitational unit of weight in MK's system is kgf, that is kilogram force, and we know that 1 kilogram force is equal to 9.8 newton. Okay, now in CGS system, the gravitational unit of weight is gram force, and 1 gram force is equal to 980 dyne. Okay, remember this, children, because this will be very useful while doing the numerical problems. Okay, so the gravitational unit of weight is kgf in MK system, and in CGS system it is GF, that is gram force. Now what should be the gravitational unit of force in MKS and in CGS system, children? Since the unit of weight and force is almost same, so here also you will find that the gravitational unit of force in MK system is kgf, that is kilogram force, and in CGS system the gravitational unit of force is GF, that is gram force. Okay, and here you know that 1 kgf is equal to 9.8 newton, similar to this, and 1 gf is equal to 980 dyne. Okay, and what is the similarity between kgf and gf, children? Kgf and gf, 1 kgf is equal to 1000 gf. 1 kgf is equal to 1000 gf. Okay, now let us discuss some questions. Here is the first question: a body falls freely under gravity from rest, okay, from rest, and reaches the ground in time t. Write an expression for the height fallen by the body. Here, an expression for height is asked. Okay, so body falls freely under gravity from rest. Rest means children, the initial velocity is nothing but equal to zero. Now you need to find an expression for the height. So we can take this one. Okay. So children, it's according to your convenience that which formula you are selecting or which equation you are selecting, but according to the given data you need to select the equation. Okay, so h is equal to ut plus half gt square. Since u is equal to 0, so h is equal to 0 into t plus half gt square. That means h is equal to half gt square. So this is the expression. Okay, now second question. A body is thrown vertically upwards with an initial velocity u. Write an expression for the maximum height attained by the body. Children, you know very well that when a body is thrown in the vertically upward direction, g is taken as negative. So I have written the expression or equations like this. Okay, minus gt, minus half gt square, minus 2gh. Okay, why? Because g is taken as negative. Because when a body is thrown vertically upward, the body is moving away from the earth's surface. So g is taken as negative. Now the body is having certain initial velocity u. Okay, what happens to the final velocity, children? You know very well that when a body is reaching to the highest point, the final velocity is becoming zero. Yes, the final velocity is becoming zero. Now here also we need to find the height. Okay, so we can take this equation. So v square is equal to u square minus 2gh, or v square, since it is 0, v square is, we can take this as 0. So 0 is equal to u square minus 2gh, or u square is equal to 2gh, or h is equal to u square by 2g. This is the expression in case a body is thrown vertically upward direction. Okay, now let us go for the third question. A body is projected vertically upward with an initial velocity u. Okay. If acceleration due to gravity is small g, the time, find the time for which it remains in air. It remains in air means here we need to find out the time starting from the body is moving in the upward direction, reaching to the highest point and again coming in the downward direction and reaching to the surface. Okay, because you can find that starting from the body moving in the upward direction till the body reaches to the earth surface, it remains in air. So we need to find the time taken, total time taken means moving in the upward direction and then coming in the downward direction. That means we need to find the total time taken here. So here the, and one thing you should remember, children, the time taken to move till the highest point and then coming will be that means a body when moving from the earth's surface to the highest point, if it is taken as t, then the time taken from the highest point to reach the earth's surface will be also same. Okay, so the total time taken here, total time taken will be t plus t, that means 2t. But how can we find t? Okay, since the body is moving in the upward direction, so we can let us first find t. Okay, t is nothing but your v minus u by g. Okay, so v minus u, actually we are taking this equation, v is equal to u minus gt. So v minus u is equal to minus gt. So v minus u by minus g. Okay, we are taking this. So here since v is equal to 0, v is equal to 0. So minus u by minus g, that is minus u by g. Okay, so what should be the total time taken, children, here? So the total time taken here will be u by g plus u by g, that means 2u by g. Okay, this is the correct answer. Okay, now next question. The value of g at the center of earth is 0. What will be the weight of the body of mass m kg at the center of earth. You know that children, the g at the center of earth is zero. So the g value varies from place to place. So at the center of earth, if g is zero, then what will be weight? M into g, that means m into zero, that means zero. So weight of the body will be zero at the center of the earth. Okay. Now let us do some numerical problems. This is the first question. A body is dropped from the top of a tower. It acquires a velocity 20 meter per second on reaching the ground. Calculate the height of the tower. Children, and here g is given as 10 meter per second square. So whenever we are getting such type of question, as I told you, you need to read the question first twice. Then you need to write the information which are given in the question and what has to be, what is asked in the question. Okay, after that you can select one equation and then you can solve the numerical question. Okay, so here you can see very clearly that g is given as 10 meter per second square. So here I want to suggest you one thing, that when g value is given as 10, you have to take 10. If it is given as 9.8, you take 9.8. But if nothing is mentioned in the question, then you have to take the accurate value of g, that is 9.8 meter per second square. Okay, so let us solve the equation numerical problem. So here I have written the equations of motion. Since the body is under free fall, that is moving in the downward direction, so g is taken as positive. Okay, so here what is given? Here g value is given as 10 meter per second, 10 meter per second square, 10 meter per second square. Children, you can write like this also, 10 m second minus 2. Okay, so this is the correct form. Okay, so now how can we find that the velocity which is given here, 20 meter per second, whether it is a initial velocity or final velocity? Children, you have to remember one thing, that whenever body is dropped from the tower or dropped from the height, then always u is taken as zero. Okay, always u is taken as zero. So here u will be zero and v is 20 meter per second. So here what is asked? Height is asked. So in the according to this question, we know what is u, what is v and g. We don't have time, so we cannot use this equation and this equation. So it's better to select this one. So v square is equal to u square plus 2gh. Okay, so v is your 20. So 20 square is equal to u is your 0 plus 210 into h. That is 400 is equal to 0 plus 20h. 400 is equal to 20h. So h is equal to 400 by 20. That means 20 meters. The unit of height is meter. Okay, so like this we can find. Now let us see the another question. A pebble is thrown vertically upward with a speed of 20 meter per second. How long will it be after 2 seconds? Children, here the body was moving in the downward direction, and in this case the body is thrown vertically upward direction. So I have written the equation taking g negative, because the body is moving in the upward direction. That means it is moving away from the earth's surface. So that's why g is taken as negative. So when you are taking the formula like this, then no need to put g is equal to minus 10, because already we have put the value of g negative in the equation. Okay, so let us write what information is given in the question. Whenever a body is thrown vertically upward direction, after reaching to the highest point, the final velocity of the body becomes zero. So you remember this, children, that whenever a body is thrown in vertically upward, always v is zero. Okay, so here v is equal to 0, u is equal to 20 meter per second, time is given 2 seconds, and g is given 10 meter per second square. So what is asked here? Here h is asked. So h is equal to question mark. We need to find h. Okay, so again we need to select one equation. Okay, so here which one? This one we can use, right? H is equal to ut minus half gt square. Okay, now put the value. U is your 20 into 2 minus half 10 into 2 square. That is 40 minus half into 10 into 4. That means 40 minus 20. It's nothing but equal to 20. So height is 20 meter. So like this we can solve numerical problems. Children, here you can see very clearly that the problem was solved based on the free fall, that is under gravity, means a body is moving in the downward direction, and in this case the body was moving in the upward direction. Okay.